faced with a belligerent mob, the implication of using too much force means non-lethal rounds become essential. Even then, the distance to your intended target dramatically influences the effectiveness of these rounds. There are two major challenges when you're dealing with blunt force trauma rounds. One, if you're too far away, I may not have enough kinetic energy when I hit you. Two, if you're too close, I may have too much kinetic energy and do massive damage. What's needed is a blunt trauma weapon system that can deliver the same punch no matter what distance the target is. That's why Beretta came up with this, the Less Than Lethal 7000.
What the LTL 7000 does is it comes up with a way to engage targets anywhere between 50 feet and 230 feet effectively.
Gabriel DiPlano oversees new product development at Beretta USA.
And therefore gives you, with one system, with one ammunition system, with one weapon system, the capability of hitting the target effectively within that range.
The secret lies in an innovative optical sight, which just uses two simple buttons to operate. The soldier matches the red dot to the height of the target seen through the scope. This quickly and accurately determines the amount of force needed. The weapon automatically uses the data from the sight to adjust a series of valves in the chamber, which bleed off more or less gas before the shot is fired. This directly affects the force of the impact, guaranteeing it stays less than lethal. Beretta calls this the constant kinetic energy system. So, when I switch from the near to the far target, I adjust the dots through the sight. This closes the valves so all the gas in the chamber is used to propel the round downrange. This gives it maximum kinetic energy.
Just like that.
Simple to operate, but no small engineering feat. In this prototype design, Beretta claims to have invented a weapon that can deliver the same amount of non-lethal force to its target no matter what range it is. I can see for myself that hitting the target is no problem, even at maximum range. But how hard am I hitting it? That's what really matters. To find out for sure, we brought in an independent expert with over 15 years' experience in blunt trauma weapons research.
What we're basically interested in is what happens when these rounds hit the body.
Cynthia Burr is the Associate Professor of Biomedical Engineering at Wayne State University.
So what we have here is a chronograph. And what happens is the projectile breaks the first beam of light, travels a foot, and breaks the second beam of light. From there, we can get our velocity. The projectile then comes and impacts the three-rib device, which has displacement sensors, which allows us to actually measure how much deflection we get from the ribs.
What we're really interested in seeing is, does the Beretta round keep the same kinetic energy at 50 as it does at 230 feet?
Range is hot.
Hitting a target 6 inches square at 50 feet isn't a problem for a professional, but would the impact kill? The test shows that the projectile hit with an impact of around 211 miles an hour, giving it enough energy to deliver sharp pain and a nasty bruise, but well within the less than lethal limit.
What do you think?
Yeah, it looks like it cracked the pad.
There you go, right there. Bing, 375 feet per second. Now, that's less than lethal. 500 feet per second is considered right on that edge. So 375, well within the parameter.
Now we move the target downrange to 230 feet, almost five times the distance. Normally, a blunt trauma weapon that works at a range of 50 feet would be useless at anything like this range. The round would slow down and probably drop to the ground before it even reached the target. But with Beretta's constant kinetic energy system, the result should be exactly the same, no matter what the range. Now let's find out if they're right.
That's a direct hit, right in the middle.
Now, we get to see what happened.
Even at this distance, the Beretta's accuracy allows me to hit the target first time. But again, it's how hard I hit the target that counts.
The thing to remember here is you want enough kinetic energy to hit that guy in the gut, knock him to the ground. You don't want to kill him.
Now, Cynthia is ready to tell us whether the constant kinetic energy system lives up to its name.
So we just got done processing our results from both tests, from our 50-foot test and our 230-foot test. What's quite amazing is that our kinetic energy stayed constant. So what you see here are the two plots. The red plot would be the test from 50 feet, and the blue plot would be the test from 230 feet. So as you can see, they're very similar in nature.
The second round hit with a velocity of around 231 miles per hour, only slightly more energy than the first, and still well within the less than lethal limit.
I've worked with Less Lethal Technologies for a number of years, and I've never seen a round that is so consistent and can go from the 50 feet out to the 230 feet without changing its kinetic energy.
The troops that are out there, they want these types of capabilities. They need them. Commanders recognize it. And we're on the verge of making these systems, these weapons, a mainstay of U.S. operations.
At this point, it is a prototype. We are working on some changes to the ergonomics of the gun, the weight of the gun, the size of the gun, to make it even more user-friendly and easier to use.
Beretta's design is a gigantic leap forward for less-than-lethal weapons technology. This is one prototype that aims to make a big impact in a future less-than-lethal world.